direct from Detroit, Motor City, USA. The Auto Channel presents exclusive press pass coverage of the North American International Auto Show.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the BMW Group Press Conference. Please welcome the President and CEO of BMW North America, Mr. Ludwig Wittisch.
Welcome to the BMW Group. For us, a focus on sustainability is part of premium mobility. A perfect example of our long-term approach is this car right here, the BMW i8 Concept. It highlights the BMW Group's commitment to progressive design, performance, and sustainability. Our long-term approach also includes a real commitment to our market. The relationship between the US and the BMW Group is a very special one. 37 years ago, we firmly established our presence in North America with our headquarters in New Jersey. We have invested $5 billion in our South Carolina plant over the last decade alone, and we recently started producing carbon fiber for i3 and i8 in Washington State. Just to be sure, the BMW Group remains as committed to America today as ever before. One of the reasons we are able to create such revolutionary vehicles like the i8 is the close connection we have with our heritage of innovation. And for decades, bringing more and more innovative 3 Series vehicles to the US has been a labor of love. Has underpinned our success here in the US. However, the BMW 3 Series sedan has defined the BMW brand in this country more than any other. Over the last 37 years, the BMW 3 Series has continued to set the benchmark as the ultimate sports sedan. It's a true sales success in America, and in fact, since the first 3 Series arrived here in 1976, more than half of all BMWs sold in the US have been 3 Series. BMW Group member responsible for sales and marketing, Ian Robertson, will tell you no more about this legendary car.
I'm really glad to be back here in the United States on what feels to be a spring morning here in Detroit. We've got a lot of good news to share with you all this morning. Now, 2011 was a historic year for the BMW Group, and playing a significant role in our worldwide success is, of course, this vehicle, the BMW 3 Series. Now, one out of every 3 BMWs sold throughout the whole world is a 3 Series. And our biggest market for the 3 Series is right here in the United States. Now, in its 6th generation, the new 3 Series again offers customers the heart of the BMW brand. Athletic design, powerful and efficient engines, and the ability to individualize each and every car. Now, take this one for example. It's currently the sportiest version of the new 3 Series, equipped with a new M Sport package. But this is only one example of how the new 3 Series can be customized. Now, of course, as every BMW, customers can configure the new BMW 3 Series with as many options as they desire. And for those customers with a design concept already in mind, we're offering three different lines. Firstly, the Sport line. Now, this aims to strengthen the car's already sporty nature. The Luxury line offers a touch of additional refinement. And the Modern line creates a harmonious interior space through natural materials. Now, whilst all these options are new, they are right in line with our long-term approach, which has always been driven to provide our customers with more options for individuality, more innovation, and of course, more performance. Now, these elements are the spirit of the ultimate driving machine, and they are in every one of our vehicles. And this has drawn more customers into our brands than ever before, and led us to another record year as a group. Now, I'm pleased to announce that 2011 was the most successful year ever for the BMW Group. We delivered over 1.66 million vehicles to customers right around the world last year. Now, how did we accomplish this? Of course, by delighting our customers with all three brands, BMW, Mini, and Rolls-Royce. Now, the BMW brand had a remarkable year, selling more than 1.38 million vehicles in 2011. And that was a 13% increase over the year before. Now, Mini continued its stellar growth, chalking up 22% over 2010, with 285,000 Minis sold all around the world last year. And the pinnacle of luxury motoring, Rolls-Royce, achieved the best sales result in its 107-year history. Now, Rolls-Royce delivered over 3,500 motor cars to customers right across the globe. Now, this performance led all three brands to achieving new global sales records. Here in the United States, 2011 was an outstanding year for the BMW Group. In fact, America is once again our largest single market, with an increase in sales of over 15%. We sold 305,000 vehicles here last year, and of that, more than 247,000 were BMWs, making BMW the top premium brand in the United States car market. Now, looking forward, we plan to capitalize on the potential that 2012 holds. The BMW brand has its youngest ever product portfolio. And to this, adding this to our sales momentum, we start 2012 with a solid foundation for further balanced growth all around the globe. And that's a really important strategic objective for us, balanced growth rather than focus on one area. Now, this strengthens our position to continue earning the title of the number one premium car company in the world. And we intend to expand our lead by focusing on both the current and future solutions. Now, in the years to come, we'll continue to develop even more efficient and, of course, dynamic internal combustion engines. And at the same time, we're also focused on creating revolutionary technologies for future mobility. Now, ladies and gentlemen, to tell you more about our approach, please welcome my colleague, the head of development for BMW, Klaus Dräger.
Ladies and gentlemen, a very warm welcome also from my side. The newest generation BMW C-Series sedan is all set writes the next chapter of this car's long success story. And the car behind me marks yet another milestone for the 3 Series. The new BMW Active Hybrid C is the first full compact hybrid in the sports sedan in the premium segment. This car is the latest in BMW efficient dynamics technology. And this hybrid combines a 6-cylinder petrol engine and an electric drive. The outcome? 3 Series driving pleasure with fewer emissions, less consumption, and even more performance. It comes with 335 horsepower and 450 newton meters of maximum torque as standard. And with 37 miles per gallon, you can experience that performance for a lot longer on the road with fewer visits to the gas station. And on top of the outstanding efficiency of the Active Hybrid C, the intelligent navigation system, the system calculates your route and it interacts with the hybrid system, allowing you to drive the last kilometers of your journey using only electric power. And this car is not only an ordinary hybrid. The approach we took in developing this vehicle extends beyond optimizing efficiency and performance. We also optimized the car's architecture. As just one example, the storage was designed with space-saving layout. The trunk offers 390 liters of cargo space with a load-through function. This makes a real difference, allowing customers full functionality in a hybrid. The Active Hybrid C will be available starting this fall. This car is the second hybrid drive model in BMW's high-volume model series. The Active 3 complements the BMW Active Hybrid 5, which is making its North American debut right here in Detroit. Ladies and gentlemen, we consider these hybrid vehicles milestones in times of changing towards zero emission driving. So our approach consists of two areas, of evolution and of revolution. And this means we will continue optimizing the combustion engine while paving the way towards e-mobility. Regarding evolution, our efficient dynamics technologies have reduced fuel consumption and carbon emissions across our model since 2007. While we're also in the midst of a revolution, today we are presenting our concept cars, the BMW i3 and the BMW i8 here in Detroit. And these vehicles represent a breakthrough in future mobility. Both models were developed as full electric or plug-in hybrid cars. Ladies and gentlemen, they are really born electric. Over there, you can see the BMW i3 concept. It will be the first purpose-designed electric car using carbon fiber in series production. And this is a truly revolution in automotive engineering. The e-drive of the BMW i3 concept and its power electronics are 100% in-house developments. And next to the i3, there is a BMW i8 concept. You may have seen it recently in the cinema in Mission Impossible 4. Not only the car is visually stunning, but it's also technically impressive. Using a plug-in hybrid drive, the BMW i8 combines sports car performance with the fuel consumption of a compact vehicle. And that's pure, emotional and sustainable. And this concept brings the next generation of high performance cars to the roads. Ian, isn't that right?
Absolutely. It certainly is, guys. But, you know, Even today, BMW is known for bringing high performance to the American roads. However, some people may not know that BMW Group also brings higher performance to American athletes as well.
Yeah, we are particularly proud of BMW's group's commitment to the US Olympic team, and we are absolutely thrilled to welcome 3 gold medalists to tell us more.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Olympic winners, Janet Evans, Brian Clay, and Apollo Ono.
And a very warm welcome to all of them joining us today. We're so glad you could actually be here. Now, Janet, I know you're a member of the BMW performance team, but you've got a special connection with BMW that actually goes back quite a while. Maybe you'd like to tell us about that.
Absolutely. I was about to make my first Olympic team when I turned 16 years old, and like any 16-year-old, I asked my mom and dad for a car, and they denied me. And they said, well, your brothers didn't get a car, my older brothers. You're not going to get a car. Crazy. And I said, well, I get up at 4 every morning to swim, and I go to work out. You don't want to drive me anymore. And they said, no car. And I said, all right, well, in a few months, if I make the 1988 Olympic team, will you buy me a car? And they said, no. And I said, all right, I guess if I win a bronze medal, will you buy me a car? And they said, no. And I said, all right, a silver? And they said, no. And I said, okay, if I win a gold medal at the 1988 Olympics, will you finally buy me a car? And they said, if you win a gold medal, which I wasn't supposed to, we will buy you any car you want. Okay, so. I had a vision in my mind for my last few months of training, and I went to the Olympics and I won my first gold medal, and my parents came down from the stands and they were all excited, they were congratulating me, and I said, okay, I want a red 325i with black leather interior, and I came home from the Olympics and it was in my driveway.
That's a great story, Jenny. I never thought as a kid to drive that, but tell me, what car are you driving today?
I am driving a 650 convertible. So it's black, not red, but I still love it just as much.
With 2 kids in the back.
With 2 kids in the back, and the car seats fit perfectly, and the stroller.
Hey, perfect.
Apollo, I understand your connection with BMW is a bit more technical.
It is. Although I am a BMW owner, my relationship with BMW was a little bit different. I think all of us is a little bit different as well. You know, as athletes, every single year, every single Olympics, we're always looking to evolve, to change our bodies, to change the way that we perform, to become more efficient, to become lighter, become faster, and overall just become better athletes. And very similar to the fact that BMW has taken their technologies and take something that's had success in the past. In my sport, such as short track speed skating, I had to minimize my weight as much as possible and still have the greatest amount of power. And over the course of the 4 to 8 years that I was training for the past 2 games, I had to slowly trim away at all the excess muscle, all the excess fat, while still intaking a very small amount of fuel, very small amount of consumption of all the foods that I was eating, and still get the maximum amount of output. And so the relationship between myself and BMW is that we both share the same values and will symbolize the same personification of we're trying to achieve something that is more efficient, that is innovative, that is dynamic, fast, and performs under any circumstance.
Although that sounds like efficient dynamics to me, so I think Clausen's team can really relate to that. Now, Brian, as a member of the performance team, I heard that you're about to start some really technical stuff. Maybe you'd like to explain what that's about.
I am. Next week, I get to have the BMW performance team come out and do some testing at the track with me. And if you know anything about the decathlon, it's 10 events. And we do over 2 days. We compete 12 to 13 hours at a time. We get about 3 hours of sleep in between the 2 days. When it comes down to becoming efficient in what we do, there is no other option. You have to be as efficient as possible. And what we're hoping to do, and what I think will happen with the testing that we're going to do, is I'll be able to get real-time data on the track. They'll have a camera out there. They're going to film me. They'll be able to tell me velocity and different information, things like that. But I'll be able to turn around after that run, walk back to the computer, get that real-time data and then implement that into my next run. We've never had that before in our sport. So really the relationship between BMW, myself, and the USOC and all the athletes, it's really about performance and making us the best possible performers, you know, that we can be, so that we can go out and hopefully win the next gold medal at the next Olympics.
Another gold medal. Thanks again to the three athletes for joining us today. It's always a pleasure. We wish them all the success, and I think we're about 200 days from the London Olympics. And as you probably know, the BMW Group is also a major sponsor of the upcoming London 2012 Games, and we are really looking forward to being part of what I think will be not only a great competition, but probably the best games ever. And I hope to see all of you there in, as I said, just a few hundred days. Thanks, ladies and gentlemen, for visiting us on the BMW stand today. Now please come up and see these great cars and the athletes that are with us. Thanks again.
Thanks for watching the Auto Channel. For more great coverage of all major motor events, visit theautochannel.com, the internet's most complete and comprehensive automotive resource.